Hi there, this is Caitlin Porter from the Mongoose Enablement Team. Welcome to part 7 of the Mongoose Hello World training series. In the previous videos, we have leveraged the powerful productivity user interface for building out the data model and UI for our store. We could run our app right now from the browser, but the UI currently requires some orientation from our users. In this video, we'll get you started with building out a zero training portal for our store. This portal will consist of 3 different screens. The first will be a customer sign-in page where they can sign in with their customer ID. The second will be a home page where they can add items to their cart by dragging and dropping. And then the third will be a cart view where they can view all of the items that they added to their cart. Okay, let's get started. Hit the designer icon from the toolbar to open up the web designer. Let's set the editing scope to site default, then hit OK. Select the new form definition icon from the toolbar, and for the category, select Flex, and for the wizard, select Basic, then hit OK. Let's pause for a second and go over the basics of Flex Forms and Flex Layout components. Flex Forms use Flex Layout components to render all other components, allowing you to create forms that are dynamically responsive to the viewing environment. This allows you to create a single form that fits in the browser, tablet, or mobile device all simultaneously. A Flex Layout component is a container component which is used to flexibly house other components. Each Flex Layout component can be divided into different horizontal or vertical regions, and each region can contain multiple child components. You can even nest Flex Layout components inside regions of other Flex Layout components. You can nest these components as many levels deep as you need to accomplish your form design. With the Flex Layout component, you can group the regions horizontally or vertically. Horizontal boxes will arrange the regions horizontally from left to right, and vertical boxes will arrange the regions vertically from top to bottom. The length and units attributes control the individual length of each region of a Flex Layout component. Length can be expressed in fixed character units, or expressed as flex units, which are equal portions of the total available width. Or most often, they can be combined to create fixed and flexible regions within a form. The orientation attribute specifies how the components should be arranged within a region. The pack and align attributes work together to position the child components. When the flex layout region is vertically oriented, use align to position the child components at the left, center, right, or to stretch them to fill the entire width of the region. Use pack to position the child components at the start, center, or end of the region. When the flex layout region is horizontally oriented, use align to position the child components at the top, middle, bottom, or to stretch them to fill the entire height of the region. Use pack to position the child components at the start, center, or end of the region. Now that we know the basics with flex forms and flex layout components, let's keep going and building our first flex form. Select OK, and when the form wizard opens, name the form Customer Portal. For the unit, you have the option to select between pixel or character. For the purposes of this demo, let's select character and then hit Next. Hit Finish to create your form. After the form opens, let's add some collections to the form. Expand the Details pane at the bottom, and under the Collections tab, select Primary Collection and set it to our Orders IDO. You should get a prompt telling you to regenerate your form. We need to add another collection to the form, so we'll do this after. Hit the new icon from the bottom, and for the secondary collection, let's set it to our items IDO. Hit OK at the second prompt, and now we can regenerate a form using the icon from the toolbar. This will save the form, close it, and reopen it all in one step. This step is necessary whenever a new collection is added to the form. Sometimes you'll also have to use this when you make UI changes. Next, let's utilize Flex Layout components to lay out our form. Select the Flex Layout component that was automatically added to our form, and then select the Edit Flex Layout Attributes button at the top left corner. The Flex Layout attributes can also be accessed from the Properties panel under Layout Flex Attributes by clicking the ellipsis. By default, the Flex Layout component arranges the regions horizontally. Let's change this so they arrange vertically. Change the type to vertical box. Select the index region 0, and let's give it an ID of header. Let's assign it a length of 4. Let's use form units, and let's set the orientation to fill. Then select index 1, and let's rename it to main. Let's give it a length of 1, a unit of flex, and an orientation of fill. Lastly, select the region index 2, and let's rename it to footer. Give it a length of 2 form units, and set the orientation to fill. Then hit OK. Next, let's build the header for our form. Grab another flex layout component and drop it into the header region. With our new component still selected, let's rename this to flex layout header. Then set the theme class to blue background. Next, select the edit flex layout attributes button in the top left corner. We're going to split this up into 2 regions, so add another region below using the icon. Rename the first region to header, give it a length of 1 flex, set the orientation to horizontal, align it to the middle, and pack, set it to start. Then select the second region. Let's give it an ID of user. Give it a length of 1 flex unit, and set the orientation to horizontal. Set the alignment to middle, and the pack to end. Let's also set a margin here. Set the margin equal to 1, 0, 0, 0. The margin is defined as left, top, right, bottom, in that order. So our default margin will set 1 care to the left, and this applies to all of the components within that region. Hit OK, and now grab a static component from the toolbox and drop it into the header region of flex layout header. Rename the component to static header. Give it a caption of S customer portal. Hit the ellipsis to create the string. And then let's set a theme class of white header. Set the justification to left. Scroll down to the layout section and set the width to 40 and the height to 1.5. Then under miscellaneous, set no colon to true. To see those changes, regenerate the form from the icon on the toolbar. Now I want to add some spacing to the left of the static component we just added. Click on the component and then hit the Edit Flex Layout Attributes button. This allows us to set a margin on just one component instead of all of the components within a region. Set the margin to 2, 0, 0, 0 to add 2 characters at the left. Next, grab 2 more static components and drop them both into the user region of Flex Layout Header. Select the first static component and rename it to Static Cust Icon. Give it a bitmap file of customericon.png. This should be one of the images that you imported in one of the earlier videos. Set the justification to right, and scroll down to the layout section and set the width to 4 and the height to 1.5. Then set no colon at the bottom to true. Select the second component and give it a name of Static Cust ID. Let's set the theme class of white header, set the justification to left, and let's bind this to a variable. Set the binding type to variable, and then in the binding field, click the ellipsis. Set it to customer ID, then hit OK. Scroll down to the layout section and set the width to 10 and the height to 1.5. Set no colon to true. To see your changes, regenerate the form. Now you can see our customer icon image and an empty static component that will be bound to our customer ID variable later on. Let's build our footer now. Grab another flex layout component from the toolbox and drop it into the footer region. Rename the component flex layout footer and then assign it the blue background theme class. Once you're done with that, regenerate the form to see your changes. Now grab another flex layout component and drop it into the main region. Rename it to flex layout main. Then click the Edit Flex Layout Attributes button in the top left corner. We need a total of 6 regions, so click the new icon on the bottom and add 5 new regions. Click Region 1 and let's rename it to Menu. Give it a length of 20 form units, an orientation of vertical, an alignment of center, and a pack of start. Let's set the margin on this to 0, 1, 0, 1. Select the second region and rename it to Spacer 1. Leave the default, which is 1 flex. Select region 3 and rename it to Sign In Page. Give it a length of 5 flex units. Set the orientation to vertical. set the alignment to center, and set the pack to start. Select region 4, and let's rename this to home page. Give it a length of 5 flex, and set the orientation to fill. Select the 5th region, and let's rename this to cart page. Give it a length of 5 flex, set the orientation to vertical, the alignment to stretch, the pack to start, and set the default margin to 0, 1, 0, 1. Select the last region and rename it to spacer 2. Leave the default of 1 flex. Now let's set maximum lengths on our regions so they don't stretch too wide across the screen. Reselect our homepage region and set the maximum length to 50. Select the cart page region and set the maximum length to 65. Once you're done with that, hit OK. Now let's create our menu on the left. Grab 3 button components and place them into the menu region of Flex Layout Main. Select the first component and rename it to Button Sign In. Give it a caption of S Sign In and create the string by clicking the ellipsis. Give it a theme class of Blue Button, and then under the Layout section, set the height to 15 and the width to 2. Select the second button and rename it to Button Home. Give it a caption of S Home and create the string value. Set the theme class to Blue Button, and then under the Layout section, set the width to 15 and the height to 2. Select the last button and let's rename it to Button Cart. Give it a caption of S Cart and then create the string value. Assign it the theme class Blue Button, and under the Layout section, set the width to 15 and the height to 2. Then regenerate your form to see your changes. Next, let's build out the customer sign-in page where they can sign in with their customer ID. Grab a static component from the toolbox and drop it into the sign-in page region of Flex Layout Main. Rename it to Static Sign-In. Give it a caption of S Sign-In. Set the theme class to Header. Set the justification to Center. And then set the width to 20 and the height to 1.5. Set no colon equal to true. Grab another static component from the toolbox and drop it into the same region. Let's name this component Static Image 1, and let's assign it the bitmap file of customersignin.png. Set the width to 21 and the height to 8. Then set no colon equal to true. Grab another static component from the toolbox and drop it into the same region. Let's name this component Static Cust ID 2 and give it a caption of S Customer ID. Click the ellipsis to create the string. Set the justification to Center and then set the width to 20 and the height to 1.5. Set no colon equal to true. Now, let's grab an edit component and drop it into the same region. Rename the component Edit Cust ID and set the justification to center. We also want to bind this to our customer ID variable. So for the binding type field, select Variables and click the ellipsis for the binding. Type in customer ID. Set the width to 20 and the height to 1.5. Now grab a button component from the toolbox and place it in the same region. Let's rename this Button Sign In 2. Give it a caption of S Sign In. And for the theme class, select Blue Button. On the size, set the width to 20 and the height to 1.5. You might need to regenerate your form here to see your changes. Select the static sign-in component and hit the Edit Flex Attributes button. Let's set a margin here. Set the margin equal to 0, 1, 0, 1, and then hit OK. Select the static image 1 component and let's set a margin there as well. Click on the component and select the Edit Flex Attributes button. Set the margin here to 0, 1, 0, 1. Then hit OK. Let's do the same for the sign in button. Click on the component and hit the Edit Flex Attributes button. Set the margin here to 0, 1, 0, 1. Then hit OK. This will apply a margin of one character at the top and one character at the bottom for the components that we specified. Now that we have our sign-in page complete, let's go ahead and save and move on to the home page. The home page will be where users can view and add items to their cart. Start by grabbing a Flex Layout component from the toolbox and dropping it into the home page region of Flex Layout Main. Rename it Flex Layout Home. Because this region is set to fill, notice that our new Flex Layout component fills up the entire region. With Flex Layout Home still selected, click the Edit Flex Attributes button. Change the type to Vertical Box, and then using the new icon on the bottom left, add 4 regions. Select the first region and rename it to Header. Give it a length of 4 form units. Set the orientation to horizontal. Set the alignment to middle and the pack to center. Select the second region and let's rename this to Spacer. Set the length as 1 form unit. Select region 3 and let's rename this to Grid. Give it a length of 2 flex and set the orientation to Fill. Then select the fourth region and rename this to Spacer 2. Give it a length of 1 form unit. Then select the last region and rename it to Buttons. Give it a length of 1 flex and set the orientation to Fill. Hit OK and then grab another Flex Layout component from the toolbox and drop it into the Buttons region of Flex Layout Home. Rename it to Flex Layout Buttons. Then select the Edit Flex Attributes button in the top left corner. Using the new icon in the bottom left, add 2 regions. Select the first region and rename it to Count. Give it a length of 1 flex and set the orientation to horizontal. Set the alignment to top and the pack to end. Select the second region and rename it to Spacer. Give it a length of 1 form unit. Then select the third region and rename it to Cart. Give it a length of 1 flex, set the orientation to horizontal and the alignment to top, and then set the pack to start. Hit OK, and then grab a static component from the toolbox and drop it into the header region of Flex Layout Home. Rename it to Static Home. Give it a caption of S Home. Set the theme class to Header. Set the justification to Center. And give it a width of 20 and a height of 1.5. Then set no colon to true. Next, grab a grid component from the toolbox and drop it into the grid region of Flex Layout Home. Rename it to Grid Items. Set the binding type to Secondary Collection. And click on the ellipsis for binding. Select our secondary collection, which is Items. Then hit OK. And then regenerate your form. Let's stop here and wrap up what we've done so far. We got you introduced to Flex Forms and Flex Layout components, and got you started building out our consumer and user interface for the customer portal. In the next video, we'll introduce you to Tile Forms, and we'll wrap up the series by completing our customer portal form. For more tutorials and documentation, check out the Mongoose portal at mongoose.infor.com. Thanks for watching.